No, you good. You good. You look good.
We're in Korea.
that's so hard. Yo, that's extremely hard.
But I also love the vibrant colors here. Everything is super multicolored. It's a super colored, vibrant city.
And something I noticed about the colors is that it's not reflecting upon what people wear. A lot of people wear black, gray, brown, just casual colors here. I'm not seeing anyone wear yellow or anything too bright. And that's funny because all the buildings kind of make up for that. So it's like a balance in a way.
Oh, that's a whole biker game.
That's so cool.
They have a tourist person that's just here to help tourists. Wow. Literally, we look lost and a tourist guy just came and was like, foreigner tourists help.
What's up guys? It's your boy Eric and welcome to the video. Right now it's about 8 in the morning. I gave myself a little extra time to sleep in because I was super tired after my travels yesterday. But today is finally the day that I'm moving out of this hotel, which I've been in for the past 9 days, the first 7 days in a forced quarantine. And I'm moving to a different part of Seoul into my dorm at Korea University. And for the next couple hours, I basically just have to get packed, make sure I have everything. So I definitely have to start working on that so I have time to get out of here at 10:30. So basically it took me like 2 hours to pack because I was just doing way too much. I bought too many heavy jackets. I bought like 2 Sherpa jackets and a couple other things, and I just packed way too many things. Tell me how I'm looking through my stuff and I found a pair of shoes that I forgot I packed, but it's just stuffed over there in the corner. So this is my tip for anyone that's traveling abroad. Don't pack too much, especially shoes. I have like 7 pairs and that's not good. I don't feel smart for doing that. But right now I'm about to head down to the lobby because I'm gonna meet up with some friends and we're gonna go run some errands. All right, so right now we are outside. We got out here at exactly 10:30 and we're gonna go ahead to go get our vaccine passes certified. So basically it's turning our CDC card in America to like a vaccine pass that works over here in Korea. And it scans at all the eat-in restaurants because usually when you say you're eating in, they require you to scan it. And the CDC pass has been working for the past couple days, but since we're in Korea, you kind of have to just go get the Korean pass. So once again, we're avoiding the outside cold by walking underneath in the subway. It's like a huge tunnel and it's gonna lead us to the train, which was like 2 or 3 blocks away. But instead of walking outside, we get to walk in this warm hallway. I know I've been away. I'm just trying to get my paper straight, girl. Don't give my shit away. So apparently there's just too many people here and it's just closed until 1 o'clock, but we have until 2 o'clock because that's when our van leaves to bring us to the university dorm. So yeah, it's kind of a tough situation because I don't need it 100%. Like I mentioned earlier, you could probably bring your CDC card at 99% of places, but I kind of want to get it out of respect, to be honest, just because it's easier and it's in their system. So basically these banners on the street, I think it's election season right now. A lot of politics over here. So they're basically just promoting themselves, but it's pretty crazy because it's a huge sign in the middle of a really busy street. Hey, that's a politician riding through the streets saying hi to everybody. That is crazy, bro. But also it's starting to snow right now, like super randomly. That's been happening for like the past 3 days. It's always just on and off. Alright, so my friends wanted to get Starbucks, so I'm at Starbucks for the 3rd day in a row. I'm not buying anything though because I spent almost $30 at Starbucks already. I bought, these are piping hot. 3 fishies for 1,000 won, which is like a dollar. These are red bean. I might have just burned my tongue. These are delicious. You know you love food slash you're hungry when you proceed to eat the food when it's burning your tongue. Maybe that's just me though.
Ah.
Come on, y'all know I had to cop the beautiful strawberries. These strawberries are too beautiful. I got to. So right now we're going back in the subway, going back to the hotel. Alright, so I'm still in the subway. Just stopped to go get some food. Got some gimbap. You know, it's crazy how you can just stop in the subway and eat. I tried asking her for water. She gave me broth. Alright, this broth is so delicious. It's like has a spicy taste. And it tastes like seafood, but it's really, really good. I'm gonna try to tell them it was delicious. Maddie sao. Maddie sao. Yeah, man. I'm unconfident when it comes to speaking other languages. It's hard. I'm not gonna lie. That's probably the thing I'm most unconfident about. I'm just not trying to mess up for some reason, but first step is trying in the first place. Bye. Okay, bye. Oh man. Alright. I got salted once again. I went all the way to the cat cafe once again. They opened at 1, but service time doesn't start until 1:40, so you can't play with the cats until 1:40 because she has to feed them. So no cats today, no cats yesterday. I was so close both times. It's actually crazy. Like 30 minutes away from closing and opening time. But it's all good because, to be honest, since I'm getting better at taking the train, I could probably just take the train here anytime I want. And this is always going to be a lit part of Seoul to me because it's the first part of Seoul I've ever been to. So I'll definitely be coming back here because I've only been here for 2 and a quarter days. Let's try these strawberries. It's crazy to think that these strawberries were only $3. And they're super small too, which honestly is a really good indicator that they're real and that they're juicy, because these days strawberries are like that big. You bite into them and there's like a big gap of air in the middle. Them GMOs are hitting different. This is the real size of a strawberry, to be honest. And honestly, it's really good to see a bunch of local businesses thriving, especially in this day and age. All right, I'm headed out now. It was a pretty good experience. I have just way too much stuff now though. This is gonna be very tough. Yeah, the setup, very labor intensive. Duffel bag with a backpack and 2 suitcases. It's like a dream. What she feels with me, she loves to be. We are here. Pretty crazy. So many suitcases, so many students. And also it's on top of a huge hill, so it's kind of dangerous getting down here. But the whole university is on top of a big hill, so it's going to be a lot of walking up and down.
Say what's up, say what's up. Hey, 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 hey. Chinese TB test. CVS TB test. If you ain't 100, think you can't sit with us. When you can't sit with us, I like bad bitches.
Mad riches. That's my boy from Singapore.
Hi, friends.
Dab me up.
Dumb?
You know, yeah, like this.
What?
And then this? Like this?
Uh-huh.
And then, alright, so look. And then you gotta go like this.
Like this?
Yeah.
Is that what you do in the States?
Yeah, that's what we do in the States. Yeah. Gotta get them right. Alright, one more time. Come on.
Alright.
No, alright. Yeah. What do y'all do in Singapore?
No, we don't do it.
Nothing?
It moves like this. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's lit. Right, that's lit.
But that left right is quite hard to get, because one of
them. Yo, these hallways low-key look old and scary.
It looks scary.
It almost looks like a zombie movie. It smells very Asian in here. It smells like scallions. Fair to say though? Everybody's sweating about us, but you only know what I told you. You only know what I show ya. Done lost too many soldiers. Put my head up. We only get older and only get older. You can't see me. Oh man, oh man. It's been a crazy day.
and it's only like 4 o'clock. Between leaving the hotel and now, it's been exactly 2 hours. Went by fast, but I'm starving right now. I'm so hungry. I've never had a single in college before, so I'll say this is pretty fair sized, but I'm gonna have to unpack and see what I need. Apparently they're not providing pillows and sheets, which is what they said they were gonna provide. So I'm gonna have to buy those or either rent those today. But before I do any shopping for dorm necessities, I have to unpack and see what I need first. So I'm actually way too hungry right now. And my roommate mentioned that we should probably go get the vaccine pass. Close at 6, it's like 4:30 right now. So I'm gonna head back out, pick up some food, and then go get our vaccine passes registered. Day is not done yet. Still have errands to run.
So right now, me and my roommate Nikita, we're walking up and down all these hills. It's actually pretty crazy. But the view from our dorm and just the university in general is amazing. So that's the plus of living on top of a hill, especially in Seoul. But this walk is gonna be brutal, I already know. Went to 7-Eleven real quick because I'm just way too hungry. Got some gimbap. It's called triangle gimbap. Samgak gimbap. So yeah, I had one for breakfast this morning. Then I had some regular gimbap at the restaurant. And now I'm having another one. But yeah, the samgak gimbap is only 1,000 won, which is like a dollar. And they're actually really, really delicious. So might be living off these for a little bit. They just want to take me off of here. They just want to knock me off my square. Look at that. I can't fake a smile, it's hard to wear. And I can't show no love, that shit too rare. Is it cause my whip so fast, you don't see no flaws? This subway is pretty advanced. People who want to stand on the right side. People who walk on the left side. It seems pretty straightforward, but I've never seen this happen in such a clean fashion before. So we're official now, except not that official because we don't have a QR code yet, which is what they really need to see at the restaurant. So we have to show this everywhere. This is showing that we're vaccinated. It's better than nothing, but we're gonna really have to carry a sheet of paper out around for like 2 to 3 months. So right now we're on the street. We're just gonna go to the first restaurant that we see, honestly. We're seeing lots of takeout restaurants, but since we just got our pass, we gotta eat in. It smells really, really good on the street. All right, that was some delicious warm food. Very good choice by us, but honestly, I'm still hungry.
Dog? Dog dumplings! Dog dumplings!
Nikita has an app where you could just scan it and it scan the Korean.
Okay.
It said dog at first. You can scan the Korean and then it tells you what it is in English. It's pretty cool. It translates right on the screen. So she makes them in the back and then she steams them right in front of you. I got 4 pork and 4 shrimp. And it was 5,000 won, which is about $5. Samdida, thank you, bye.
Wow, that tastes like my mom's cooking. So that's how you know it's pretty authentic. Wow. That's really good.
Yeah, I took the biggest L. Went to 7-Eleven, bought my waters, left my dumplings there. So now your boy is about to run all the way back down and up the hill to go get them, hoping that they're there. I don't know why I feel like the person's just gonna throw them away, but it's still worth it. I need those dumplings.
This was one of my most interesting choices ever. I just had a random burst of energy, but this hill's no joke. I'm telling you guys. I'm gonna have to figure a way around this. You can't even see the bottom of this hill. That's how you know it's bad. But I had to.
Bag is secured. Can't believe I just ran back down to that 7-Eleven because I forgot my dumplings. It's been a crazy day. Clearly, I'm not thinking rationally. I'm sweating and it's like 25 degrees outside. It was so cold. The dumplings though, it's for the dumplings. Also, I just want to stretch my legs, but I don't think stretching my legs was the right thing to do. Not today, not tonight, not at this moment. It was an experience though. I feel like I just traveled through a portal, to be honest. Or maybe that's just how my days felt.